Oh, yeah.
It was Friday morn when we set sail. We were not far from the land. When our captain, he spied a meadow bay so fair, with the comb and the glass in our hand. And the ocean waves do roll, and the stormy winds do blow. And we poor sailors are skipping at the top, where the landlubbers lie down below, 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 where the landlubbers lie down below.
Then up spoke the captain of our gallant ship, and a fine old man was he. This fishy mermaid has warned me of our doom. We shall sink to the bottom of the sea.
And the ocean waves do roll, and the stormy winds do blow. And we poor sailors are skipping at the top, where the landlubbers lie down below, below, below. Where the landlubbers lie down below.
Of our gallant ship, and a fine young man was he, saying, I have a wife in Boston by the sea, and tonight a widow she will be.
And the ocean waves do roll, and the stormy winds do blow, and we poor sailors are skipping at the top, where the landlubbers lie down below, below, below. Lie down below.
And up spoke a cook of our gallant ship, a crazy old butcher was he. Shall I care much more for my pots and my pans I do for the bottom of the sea?
And the ocean waves do roll, and the stormy winds do blow. Poor sailors are skipping at the top, while the landlubbers lie down below, below, below. While the landlubbers lie down below.
And up spoke the cabin boy of our gallant ship, and a well-spoken lad was he. Said, I have a sweetheart in sailing by the sea, and tonight she'll be weeping for me.
And the ocean waves do roll, and the stormy winds do blow, and we poor sailors are skipping at the top, where the landlubbers lie down below, 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 where the landlubbers lie down below. And three times round spun our gallant ship, and three times round spun she, and three times round spun our gallant ship, and she sank to the bottom of the sea. And the ocean waves do roll, and the stormy winds do blow, and we poor sailors are skipping at the top, while the landlubbers lie down below, 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 while the landlubbers lie down below.
Thank you. That was the story of the mermaid. And in case you don't know it, or don't know us, our nephew, Robbie O'Connell.
How you doing?
And Liam Clancy. Bobby Clancy. And the new generation, Finbar Clancy. Finbar is Bobby's son, and I'm their father, Paddy Clancy.
Yes, go on. The handsomest, the richest.
The youngest, the handsomest, and the richest.
The richest, by far. That's certainly truth, yes. No two ways about that.
And the bitchiest, we forgot to add that.
Well, I have to be the shanty man, since you were all something in that bloody song except me. Oh, I feel very left out.
Oh, get the fiddle out quick, will you?
This is kind of a sad occasion, isn't it, really? It was 1954 since I stood on this stage the last time with the Playboy of the Western World on its countrywide tour from Carrick to Clonmel and back. I got a long way. But this is our last hurrah, so it's nice to have you all here tonight and be part of this. The herring are not in the tide as they were of old, my sorrow. For many's the creek gave the creel of the cart that carried the take to Sligo town to be sold when I was a boy with never a crack in my heart. With our nets and gear we're faring on the wild and wasteful ocean. It's out there on the deep that we harvest and reap our bread. As we hunt the bunny shoals of herring, it was on a fair and a pleasant day out of Yarmouth Harbour I was faring, as a cabin boy on a sailing lugger for to hunt the bunny shoals of herring. Oh, we left the home grounds in on the month of June, and for canny shields we soon were bearing, with the 100 crown of the silver darlings that we'd taken from the shoals of herring. Now the work was hard and the hours were long, and the treatment sure it took some bearing, and I used to sleep standing on me feet, and I dream about the shoals of herring. Now you're up on deck, you're a fisherman, and you're learning all about seafaring. That's your education, straps of navigation, as you hunt the funny shoals of herring. In the stormy seas and the living gales, I earned the gear that I was wearing. Sailed 10,000 miles, caught 10 million fishes, as we hunted for the shoals of herring. And it's night and day we're faring. Come winter wave or winter gale, sweating our cold, growing up, growing old, or dying, we will hunt the bunny shoals of herring.
Too soon to tell that story, isn't it?
Our brother Tom died about 5 years ago. Rest his soul. Tom and I grew up together. We went through that worst part of anyone's life together. That's puberty. We were absolutely terrified. I remember the first dance we went to. We were so excited. and so nervous. A combination of excitement and nervousness can make you do almost anything. But we had the problem of getting the money to get into the dance. We could always coax that out of our mother, but we couldn't. We had to get a little more money for a small bottle of Courage, Power's gold-labeled whiskey, a baby Power. And we had to keep this a hide from our parents. Tom had it in his back pocket a hide, and we were upstairs combing our hair for the 16th time, making sure our tie was straight and the short was clean. It was getting nearer and nearer the time for the dancing. We were getting more nervous all the time. Eventually, we had to leave. Down the stairs, Tom slipped on the bloody stairs. There was an awful crash. He put back his hand. He felt the wet. He looked up at me and he said, "Paddy, I hope it's blood."
And that dance was in the Collins Hall, wasn't it?
Well, it was in the Foresters Hall in Carrickonshire. And here's a little song, Mountain Dew.
Hi diddly hi lum diddly you diddly lum diddly you ride diddly I day. Hi diddly hi lum diddly you diddly lum diddly you ride diddly I day.
Let grasses grow and waters flow in a free and easy way. But give me a number of the fine old stuff that's made near Galway Bay. And these men all from Donegal, Sligo and Leitrim too. We'll give them the slip when we take a sip at the real old Mountain Dew.
Hi, diddly, hi, lum, diddly, you, diddly, lum, diddly, you, ride, diddly, hi, day. Hi, diddly, hi, lum, diddly, you, diddly, lum, diddly, you, ride, diddly, hi, day.
At the foot of the hill, there's a neat little still where the smoke curls up to the sky. By the smoke and the smell, you can plainly tell that the Butchin Dew are nearby. It fills the air with odor rare, and betwixt both me and you. When home you stroll, you can take a bowl of the bucket at the Mountain Dew.
Hi, diddly, hi, lum, diddly, you, diddly, lum, diddly, you, ride, diddly, I day. Hi, diddly, hi, lum, diddly, you, diddly, lum, diddly, you, ride, diddly, I day. Now learned men who use the pen have wrote your praises high. That sweet poutine from Ireland's green is still from wheat and rye. Throw away your pills, it'll cure all ills, be a pagan, a Christian, or Jew. Take off your coat and grease your throat from the real old Mountain Dew. Hi, diddly, hi, lum, diddly, you, diddly, lum, diddly, you, ride, diddly, I, day. Hi, diddly, hi, lum, diddly, you, diddly, lum, diddly, you, ride, diddly, I, day. Hi, diddly, hi, lum, diddly, you, diddly, lum, diddly, you, ride, diddly, I, day.
Thank you. In the 18th century, rebellion seemed to break out all over the world. You had the French Revolution, you had the American War of Independence, and in Ireland here, we had the Rebellion of 1798. That rebellion is now mostly remembered for one young man who played a very brave part in it. And for his effort, he was hanged by the neck in his own hometown, Tonbridge, County Antrim. His name was Roddy McCorley.
Oh, see the fleetfoot hosts of men who speed with faces wan. From farmstead and from fisher's cot along the banks of Bann, they come with vengeance in their eyes. Too late are they. For young Roddy McCorley goes to die on the bridge of Toon today. Up that narrow street he stepped, smiling proud and young. About the hemp on his neck, the golden ringlets slung. There is never a tear in his blue eyes, but glad and bright are they. As young Roddy McCorley goes to die on the bridge of Toon today.
When he last stepped off the street, his shining Viking heart. Behind him marched in grim array, a stalwart earnest band. For Antrim town, for Antrim town, he led them to the fray. And young Ronnie McCormie goes to die on the bridge of Toome today. There is never a one of all your dead who bravely fell in fray. That he who marches to his fate on the bridge of Toome today. To the last, it treads the upward way. And young Roddy McCormie goes to die on the bridge of Toome today.
Matrimony is a most peculiar institution, and it's a real love-hate relationship. The one thing about it is it goes on too long, for one thing. And there's a... there's a song about a couple who are fed up with each other, and in this case, she tried to get rid of him by... going to a quack doctor and getting some ingredients to make him blind. And then when he couldn't see what was happening, she tried to drown him. Here's a little Irish love song from the County Wexford called The Old Woman from Wexford. There was an old woman in Wexford town did dwell. She loved her husband dearly, but another man twice as well. With me rifle, little Delaney, and me rifle, orderly. One day she went to the doctor, some medicine for to find. Said, doctor, give me something that'll make me husband blind. With me rifle, little Delaney, and me rifle, orderly. He said, feed them eggs and marrow bones and make them sup them all. It won't be so very long after that till he won't see you at all. With me rifle, little Delaney, and me rifle, orderly. So she fed them eggs and marrow bones and make them sup them all. It wasn't so very long after that till he couldn't see the wall. With me rifle, little Delaney, and me rifle, orderly. Says he, I'd go and drown myself, but that might be a sin. Says she, I'll go to the water's edge and I'll help to push you in. With me rifle, little Delaney, and me rifle, orderly. The old woman, she went back a bit to get to run and go. The old man lightly stepped aside and she went in below. With me rifle, little Delaney, and me rifle, orderly. Oh, how loudly did she roar and how loudly did she bawl. And I howled your wished old woman, says he, sure I can't see you at all. With me rifle, little Delaney, and me rifle, orderly. Now she swam and swam and swam and swam and she came to the further brim. The old man got a long lash pull and he pushed her further in. With me rifle, little Delaney, and me rifle, orderly. Now eggs are eggs and marrow bones might make your husband blind. But if you want to drown him, you must creep up close behind. With me rifle, little Delaney, and me rifle, orderly.
Back about 12 or 13 years ago, I came across a most unusual song. It was a recently written song, but written about events in the latter half of the last century. A man called Peter Jones, who lives outside Washington, D.C., over in America, came across a bunch of old letters that had been passed down in his family and had survived throughout the years. And they were written by his, rather to his great-great-grandfather from by some of the family back here in Ireland. And it chronicles the family through that very turbulent time at the end of the last century. and gives you a real sense of the loss and the separation they felt, the ones who had emigrated. Something like only 1 in 10 that went out to America in those years ever made it back to Ireland again. But the family in Ireland that sent over the letters lived in a place up in County Mayo called Kilkelly. Kilkelly, Ireland, 1860, my dear and loving son John. Your good friend, schoolmaster Pat McNamara, so good as to write these words down. Your brothers have all gone to find work in England. The house is so empty and sad. The crop of potatoes is sorely infected. A third to a half of them bad. And your sister Bridget and Patrick O'Donnell are going to be married. Says not to work on the railroad, be sure to come on home soon. Kilkelly, Ireland, 1870, my dear and loving son John. Hello to your missus and to your four children. May they grow healthy and strong. Michael has got in a wee bit of trouble. I suppose that he never will learn. Because of the dampness, there's no turf to speak of. And now we have nothing to burn. And Bridget is happy. Child for her, although she's got six of her own. You say you found work, but you don't say what kind or when you will be coming home. Michael and John, my sons, I'm sorry to give you the very sad news that your dear old mother has gone. We buried her down at the church in Kilkelly. Your brothers and Bridget were there. To worry, she died very quickly. Remember her in your prayers. And it's so good to hear that Michael's returning. With money he's sure to buy land. For the crop has been poor and the people are selling at any price that they can. I must be close on 80. It's 30 years since you've gone. Because of all of the money you sent me, I'm still living out on my own. Michael has built himself a fine house and Bridget's daughters ago. And thank you for sending your family picture. They're lovely young women and men. You say that your mighty don't come for a visit. What joy to see you. John, I'm sorry I didn't write sooner to tell you that Father passed on. He was living with Bridget, she says he was cheerful and healthy right down to the end. And you should have seen him play with the grandchildren. McNamara, your friend. And we buried him alongside of Mother down at the Kilkelly churchyard. He was a strong and a feisty old man, considering his life was so hard. And it's funny about you, he called for you at the end. Oh, why don't you think about coming to visit? We'd all love to see you again.
When we started out first touring Ireland, it was a great pleasure to go to Belfast. There was great energy in that city. And some of the best of our songs came from there. This one was a song we got from an old friend, Davy Hammond, about his childhood when the children would be dancing in and out among the dusty bluebells, as he said. It's called I'll Tell Me Ma When I Go Home That the Boys Won't Leave the Girls Alone.
And sing along with us and enjoy it.
And tell me, Ma, when I go home, the boys won't leave the girls alone. They prune my hair, they store my comb, but that's all right till I go home. She is handsome, she is pretty, she is the belle of Belfast City. She is the fortune, 1, 2, 3, please will you tell me who is he? Albert Mooney says he loves her, all the boys are fighting for her. They're rapping the door, they're ringing the bells, you know my true love, are you well? Out she comes as white as snow, rings on her fingers, bells on her toes. Oh, Johnny Murray says she'll die, she doesn't get the fellow with a roving eye. Let the wind and the rain and the hail blow high, the snow comes travelling from the sky. She's as nice as apple pie, she'll get her own lad by and by. When she gets a lad of her own, she won't tell her ma when she comes home. Let them all come as they will, for his Albert Moody she loves still. And tell me ma, when I go home, the boys won't leave the girls alone. They pull my hair, they stole my comb, but that's all right till I go home. She is handsome, she is pretty, she is the belle of Belfast City. She is a courtin', 1, 2, 3, please will they tell me who is he? Albert Moody says he loves her, all the boys are fighting for her. Rap at the door, they ring at the bell, saying, oh my true love, are you well? Out she comes as white as snow, rings on her fingers, bells on her toes. Oh, Johnny Murray says she'll die, she doesn't get the fellow with a roving eye. Let them all come as they will, for it's Albert Moody she loves still.
You know, this group has been on the road a long, long,
long,
long, long, long, long time. And back in that time, when it was kind of dangerous to sing, if you know what I mean, you had to go to all sorts of peculiar places. There was no such thing as the hotels. There was always a little dust house here somewhere or else. Lousy lodgings, as Paddy says. And one of the worst places, I suppose, we ever stayed was a little place outside Glasgow. And here's a story about that particular night. It was the night that we spent in Rotzio.
Dirma-doo-a-dum-a-day, dirma-doo-a-dad-mo, dirma-doo-a-dum-a-day, the night we went to Rotzio.
One New Year's Eve in Glasgow town, when all we had was half a crown, a bunch of us thought we'd prowl around and find some fun in Rotzio.
We wandered down Victoria Street, and we didn't care for the snow or sleet, and at 2:30 with aching feet, we found ourselves in Rotzio.
Dirma-doo-a-dum-a-day, dirma-doo-a-dad-no, dirma-doo-a-dum-a-day, the night we went to Rotzio.
Liam Clancy here, who's a bit of a lout, said he'd treat us all to a pint of stout. So as quick as a wink, we all set out for a public house in Rotzio.
Said I, my lads, I'd like to sing.
Said I, I'll no do such a thing.
I said, clear the room and we'll make a ring and I'll fight you all in Rotzio.
Dirma-doo-a-dum-a-day, dirma-doo-a-dad-no, dirma-doo-a-dum-a-day, the night we went to Rotzio.
Then we had to find a place to sleep.
We were all too drunk to even creep.
We found a place that was really cheap in a boarding house in Rotzio.
Then we all lay down to take our ease when somebody happened for to sneeze. And he
wakened half a million fleas in a single room in Rotzio. Dirma-doo-a-dum-a-day, dirma-doo-a-dad-no, dirma-doo-a-dum-a-day, the night we went to Rotzio.
There were several different kinds of pests.
They ran and jumped inside our vests.
They got in our hair and they built their nests. And they cried,
hurrah for Rotzio!
Says I think we'll head for home.
And we swore we never more would roam. And we're scratching still as we sing the song of the night we went to Rotzio. Dirma-doo-a-dum-a-day, dirma-doo-a-dad-no, dirma-doo-a-dum-a-day, the night we went to Rotzio. Dirma-doo-a-dum-a-day, dirma-doo-a-dad-no, dirma-doo-a-dum-a-day, the
night we went to Rotzio. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Back in the early days when we were starting out in Greenwich Village in New York, there was a character who used to come to all the shows, a young fellow of about 17 or 18 named Robert Zimmerman, better known now as the legendary Bob Dylan. But he used to follow us around and he'd make songs, his own songs, to the different tunes that we would sing. I remember meeting him on the street one morning and he was always dancing around kind of with the balls of his toes, you know. He said, hey man, hey, I wrote a song last night to Brendan on the Moor, you want to hear it? Which Brendan on the Moor was our big opening song at the time. And I said, I'm in a terrible rush. I'm going to rehearsal. How many verses are in it? He said, only 17, man. I said, well, could you give me 5 of them? You know, like, there's only 4 of us in the group and a chorus. He said, man, it's a story. I got to tell you the whole thing. And he sang it for me right there on the street. I instantly forgot it. Anyway, the song that we're going to sing is Bob Dylan's version of Willie Brennan. He changed it to be about a gambling man down in the Mississippi River. And it's the very first track on a new album that we have out. How ironical now that this is our farewell concert tour, that a very brand new album is about to come on the shelves.
Well, really, it's the first of our farewell tours, really.
Who do you think you are, Frank Sinatra? But at the irony of it is that it should also be called Older But No Wiser.
Right, Myra?
And Bobby's wife, Myra, is the one who named it and christened it. with several bottles of champagne. Here's the story of Willie Connolly, Ramblin' Gamblin' Willie.
Come around, you roving gamblers, the story we will tell about the greatest gambler, you all should know him well. His name was Willie Connolly, and he gambled all his life. He had 27 children, yet he never had a wife. And that's right, Willie, right. Roll, Willie, roll, wherever you're a gambling, now nobody really knows.
Sailing down the Mississippi to the town of New Orleans, there was a famous card game on the Jackson River Queen. I've come to win some money, old gambling Willie said. And when the game was ended up, the whole damn boat was his.
And it's right, Willie, right. Roll, Willie, roll, wherever you're a gambling, now nobody really knows.
Up in the Rocky Mountains in a town called Cripple Creek, they had an all-night poker game that lasted about a week. 900 miners had laid their money down. When Willie finally left the room, he owned the whole damn town.
And it's right, Willie, right. Roll, Willie, roll, wherever you're a gambling, now nobody really knows.
Now Willie had a heart of gold, and this I know is true. He supported all his children and all their mothers too. He wore no rings or fancy things like other gamblers wore. He spread his money far and wide to help the sick and poor.
And it's right, Willie, right. Roll, Willie, roll, wherever you're a gambling, now nobody really knows.
Late one fateful evening as they played a poker game, a man lost all his money, he said Willie was to blame. He shot poor Willie through the heart, it was a tragic fate. When Willie's cards fell on the floor, there were aces backed with eights.
And it's right, Willie, right. Roll, Willie, roll, wherever you're a gambling, now nobody really knows. So all you roving gamblers, wherever you might be, the moral of this story is very plain to see. Make your money while you can before you have to stop. For when you pull a dead man's hand, your gambling days are up. And it's right, Willie, right. Roll, Willie, roll, wherever you're a gambling, now nobody really knows. Right, Willie, right. Roll, Willie, roll, wherever you're a gambling, now nobody really knows.
This is a very different kind of a love song. It's about an old couple who know what love is all about, because their love has been tempered by the tough times as well as the good times. And there's an awful lot of friendship gone into it, which is really what it's all about in the long run, when everything else gives out. Right, Bobby?
Paddy. It was Paddy last night, it was me tonight. And Liam's time is coming, his time is coming.
Let's face it, we're all like old cars, bits falling off here and bits falling off there.
Speak for yourself, son.
I know my clutch is gone anyway. What was I saying? I won't. Just for that now, I won't bloody well sing it at all.
Well, sing it anyway.
It's about an old couple who live in a flat in Amsterdam in Holland. The old man is a bit shell-shocked. Or maybe he's, as we say down in Carrick, he's just away with the fairies. But he wanders off down by the canals of Amsterdam in the morning, shouting at the captains of the barges and the tugboats as they pass by. He thinks he knows them all from his youth in Rotterdam. But as the day wears on, he can't remember who he is or where he is or how to get home. And his old wife, Margaret, has to go and find him. I'm very fond of Margaret. She brings him back through the cobbled streets of Amsterdam. And in the cold of the evening, she puts a little whiskey in his tea to warm him up and cheer him up. If I could find a woman like that, oh my God. If I could find a cup of tea like that. lovely chorus to it if you want to sing it nice and soft with us. It says, let us go to the banks of the ocean, where the walls rise above the Zuider Zee. Long ago I used to be a young man, and dear Margaret remembers that for me. It's called The Dutchman. The Dutchman's not the kind of man to keep his thumb jammed in the dam that holds his dreams in. But that's a secret only Margaret knows. When Amsterdam is golden in the morning, Margaret brings him breakfast. She believes him. He thinks the tulips bloom beneath the snows. He's mad as he can be, but Margaret only sees that sometimes. Sometimes she sees her unborn children in his eyes. Let us go to the banks of the ocean, where the walls rise above the Zuider Zee. Long ago, I used to be a young man, and dear Margaret remembers that for me. The Dutchman still wears wooden shoes. His cap and coat are patched with love that Margaret sewed him. Sometimes he thinks he's still in Rotterdam. He watches tugboats down canals and calls out to them when he thinks he knows the captain. Till Margaret comes to take him home again, through unforgiving streets that trip him though she holds his arm. Sometimes he thinks that he's alone and he calls her name. Let us go to the banks of the ocean, where the walls rise above the Zuider Zee. Long ago, I used to be a young man, and dear Margaret remembers that for me. The windmills swirl the winter in. She winds his muffler tighter. They sit in the kitchen. The tea with whiskey keeps away the dew. He sees her for a moment, calls her name. She makes his bed up, humming some old love song. She learned it when the tune was very new. He hums a line or two. They hum together in the night. The Dutchman falls asleep and Margaret blows the candle out. Let us go to the banks of the ocean, where the water rise above the Zuider Zee. Long ago, I used to be a young man, and dear Margaret remembers that for me.
Sing it once with us.
Let us go to the banks of the ocean, where the walls rise above the Zuider Zee. Long ago, I used to be a young man, and dear Margaret remembers that for me.
Wet me whack, fall the dough, fall the diddly idly.
And wet me whack, fall the dough, fall the diddly idly.
As I rode out through Galway town to seek for recreation, the 17th of August, my mind been elevated. There was multitudes assembled with their tickets at the station. My eyes began to dazzle and I go to see the races. Wet me whack, fall the dough, fall the diddly idly.
With sugar sticks and dainties, lozenges and oranges and lemonade and raisins and gingerbread and spices to accommodate the ladies, and a big crew being for toppings to be picking while you're able.
With me whack, follow the dough, follow the diddly-idly.
It's there you'll see the pipers and the fiddlers competing, the nimble-footed dancers and the tripping on the daisies, others crying cigars and lights and bells for all the races, with the colours of the jockeys and the price and horses' ages.
Whip me whack, follow the dough, follow the diddly-idly.
There was passengers from Limerick and more from Tipperary, boys from Connemara and the Clare unmarried maidens, and people from Cork City who were loyal, true and faithful. They brought home the Fenian prisoners from dying in foreign nations.
Whip me whack, follow the dough, follow the diddly-idly.
Just there you see the jockeys and they're bound to dance so stately. The red, the blue, the orange, the green, the emblem of our nation. When the bell was rung for starting, all the horses seemed impatient. I thought they never stood on ground, their speed was so amazing.
Whip me whack, follow the dough, follow the diddly-idly. There was half a million people there of all denominations, the Catholic, the Protestant, the Jew and Presbyterian. There was yet no animosity, no matter what persuasion, but fortune, hospitality, inducing fresh acquaintance. With me whack, follow the dough, follow the diddly idly. With me whack, follow the dough, follow the diddly idly.
When I was a little boy, so my mother told me, Timmy,
way haul away, we'll haul away, Joe.
That if I did not kiss the girls, my lips would all grow moldy, Timmy,
way haul away. Ship now is rolling to me. Way haul away, we'll haul away, Joe.
King Louis was the king of France before the revolution.
Way haul away, we'll haul away, Joe.
And then he got his head cut off. It spoiled his constitution.
Way haul away, we'll haul away, Joe.
St. Patrick was a gentleman. He came from decent people to me.
Way haul away, we'll haul away, Joe.
He built a church in Dublin town and on it put a steeple to me.
Way haul away, we'll haul away, Joe. Now way haul away, we're bound for better weather to me. Way haul away, we'll haul away, Joe.
Up she flew.
Hey.
That's a girl.
Thank you.
not the leader of Liverpool that grieves me. But my darling, when I think of thee,
when I shipped on board the Yankee ship, a big pocket is her name, and Burgess is the captain of her. They say that she's a floating shame.
So fare thee well, my own true love, and when I return united we will be. It's not the leader of Liverpool that grieves me, but my darling, when I think of thee.
I have sailed with barges once before, and I think I know him right well. If a man is a seaman, he can get along, but if not, he is sure in hell.
Let's hear you all, huh?
So fare thee well, my own true love, and when I return united we will be. It's not the leaving of Liverpool that grieves me, but my darling, when I think of thee. Oh, the sun is on I could remain, for I know it will be some long time before I see you again. So fare thee well, my own true love, and when I return united we will be. It's not the leaving of Liverpool that grieves me, but my darling, when I think of thee.
Once more.
So fare thee well, my own true love, and when I return united we will be. It's not the leaving of Liverpool
in the year of our Lord, 1806, we sailed out from Cove for New York on a strange ship with a strange cargo. She was known as the Irish Rover.
In the year of our Lord, 1806, we set sail from the cold airport of Cork. We were sailing away with the cargo of bricks for the Grand City Hall in New York. We'd an elegant craft, she was rigged fore and aft, and how would the trade winds drove her? She has 23 masts, and she stood several masts, and they called her the Irish Rover.
There was Barney McGee from the banks of the Lee, there was Hogan from County Tyrone. There was Johnny McGurk, who was scared stiff of work, and a chap from Westmead named Below.
We had Slugger O'Toole, who was drunk as a rule, fighting Bill Tracy from Dover, and your man Nick McCann from the
was the skipper on the Irish Rover.
He had 1 million bags of the best Sligo rags, near 2 million barrels of bone. We had 3 million bales of our nanny goat's tail, with 4 million barrels of stone.
We had 5 million hogs and 6 million dogs and 7 million barrels of porter. We had 8 million sides of our blind horses hide in the hold of the Irish Rover. We had sailed 7 years when the measles broke out and our ship lost her way in a fog.
Hold it.
They were good. They were
good.
I wasn't.
That was the most feeble, great fog that I ever heard in
Jesus
my entire life.
Jesus Cockburn, I thought you'd do better than that.
You had two little words, great fog, and you blew it. Right in front of God and the television and everybody, you blew it.
Give me another chance.
Let's try it again. We had sailed
7 years when the measles broke out and our ship lost her way in the fog. And the whale of the crew was reduced down to two, was myself and the captain's old dog. When the ship's rocked a rock, oh Lord, what a shock, and nearly tumbled over, turned nine times around.
Cut. I said cut. You wouldn't bloody well sing when I asked you to sing. And now when I say cut, you're singing.
And the poor old dog was drowned. I'm the last of the Irish Rover.
Okay, bye-bye now. Bye-bye.
God, I have to sit down on this one. I'm getting very old, you know. And the band played Waltzing Matilda. Now when I was a young man, I carried me pack, and I lived the free life of the rover. From the Murray's green basin to the dusty outback, I waltzed my Matilda all over. Then in 1915, my country said, son, it's time to stop rambling, there's work to be done. So they gave me a tin hat and they gave me a gun, and they sent me away to the war. And the band played Waltzing Matilda as the ship pulled away from the quay. Amid all the tears, flag waving and cheers, we sail off for Gallipoli. Well, I remember that terrible day when our blood stained the sand and the water, and how in that hell that they called Suvla Bay, we were butchered like lambs at the slaughter. Johnny Turk, he was ready, oh, he'd primed himself well. He rained us with bullets and he showered us with shell. And in 5 minutes flat, we were all blown to hell. Nearly blew us back home to Australia. And the band played Waltzing Matilda when we stopped to bury our slain. And we buried ours, and the Turks bury theirs. and it started all over again. Those who are living just try to survive in that mad world of blood, death, and fire. And for 10 weary weeks, I kept myself alive, though around me the corpses piled higher. Then a big Turkish shell knocked me arse overhead, and when I awoke in my hospital bed and saw what it had done, then I wished I were dead. I never knew there were worse things than dying, for no more I'll go waltzing Matilda all around the green bush far and near. For to hump tent and pegs, a man needs both legs. No more waltzing Matilda for me. They collected the wounded, the crippled, the maimed, and they shipped us back home to Australia. The armless, the legless, the blind, the insane, those proud wounded heroes of Suvla. And when the ship pulled into Circular Quay, I looked at the place where my legs used to be, and thank Christ there was no one there waiting for me. To grieve and to mourn and to pity, and the band played Waltzing Matilda as they carried us down the gangway. But nobody cheered, they just stood there and stared. Then they turned all their faces away. So now, every April, I sit on my porch and I watch the parade pass before me. And I see my old comrades, how proudly they march, renewing their dreams of past glory. I see the old men, all tired, stiff and sore, the weary old heroes of a forgotten war. And the young people ask, what are they marching for? And I ask myself the same question. And the band plays Waltzing Matilda, and the old men still answer the call. But as year follows year, more old men disappear. Someday no one will march there at all. Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda, who'll come a waltzing Matilda with me? And their ghosts may be heard as they march by the billabong. Who'll come a waltzing Matilda with me?
We're going to sing an old favorite of ours, a song we've been singing for at least 65 years. It's a song, It's a song we learned donkeys years ago here in Ireland. An old man taught it to us. An old man whose whole life had been sweetened by the drinking of punch. And one night in this pub, he'd been there all day. He growled out this song for us as the world was slipping out of focus for him. The song that starts out very quietly and very poetically and rapidly deteriorates. We'd like you to join us in a jug of punch. One pleasant evening in the month of June, as I was sitting with my glass and spoon, a small bird sat on an ivy bunch, and the song he sang was the jug of punch. Toralo, 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 toralo. A small bird sat on an ivy bunch, and the song he sang was the jug of punch. What more diversion can a man desire than to sit him down by an alehouse fire? Upon his knee a pretty wench, aye, and on the table a jug of punch. The doctors come with all their art, they'll make no impression upon my heart. Even the cripple forgets his hunch when he's snug outside of a jug of punch. If I get drunk, well, the money's me own, and them don't like me, they can leave me alone. I'll shun me fiddle and I'll rosin me bow, and I'll be welcome wherever I go. While we're on the subject, Ishkabaha is the water of life, the origin of the word whiskey. There was a builder's laborer in Dublin in the last century who was very fond of the same water of life. And one Monday morning, after a wonderful weekend, he felt awful. He had a mother and father of a hangover. But being a builder's laborer, he still had to climb that ladder with a hod full of bricks. So to give himself a little courage, the poor man, he took a drop of the hard stuff. The result of which was, when he got to the top of the ladder, he got a dizzy spell. He fell, broke his skull, dead as a doornail.
They say it was the drop that killed him.
Tim Finnegan lived in a walking street, a gentle Irishman by the arm. He had a brogue so rich and sweet, and the rise in the world he carried on. You see, in a sort of a tippler's way, with the love for the liquor poor Tim was born. To help him on with his work each day, the drop of the crater every morn. Back on the Nano, Nancy, a partner, went to the floor, your colour's shame. Wasn't it the truth they told you? Lots of fun at Finnegan's wake.
One morning Tim felt rather full, his head felt heavy, which made him shake. He fell from a ladder and he broke his skull, and they carried him home, his corpse to wake. They rolled him up in a nice clean sheet, and they laid him out upon the bed, with a bucket of whiskey at his feet and a barrel of porter on his head.
Whack for the Nano, Nancy, a partner, went to the floor, your cutter shake. Wasn't it the truth that showed you lots of fun at Finnegan's wake?
His friends assembled at the wake, and Mrs. Finnegan called for lunch, but she served them tea and cakes, then pipes, tobacco, and whiskey punch. Biddy O'Brien began to cry. What a nice thing corpse did you ever see? Tim of morning, why did you die? And how old your cop said Billy McGee?
And fight for the land of Nancy, your partner, went to blow your trotter shake. Wasn't it the truth they told you? Lots of fun at Finnegan's wake.
And Maggie O'Connor took up the job. Oh, Biddy, says she, you're wrong, I'm sure. But Biddy gave her a belt in the gob, and she left her sprawling on the floor.
And the ward is soon engaged, was woman to woman and man to man. Shillelagh law was all the rage, and a row and eruption soon began. Back for the man who next to your partner went to floor your trotter's shake. Wasn't it the truth they told you? Lots of fun at Finnegan's wake.
Mickey Maloney ducked his head when a bucket of whiskey flew at him. It missed and fallen on the bed. The liquor scatters over Tim, and by God he revives. See how he rises, Timothy rising from the bed, saying, whirl your whiskey around like blazes. On a Monday, do you think I'm dead?
Whack for the Nano, dance your partner, went to floor your trotter shake. Wasn't it the truth they told you? Lots of fun at Finnegan's wake. Whack for the Nano, dance your partner, went to floor your trotter shake. Wasn't it the truth they told you? Lots of fun at Finnegan's wake.
How's your old one?
Game ball.
We're going to finish up with this one, believe it or not, because our time has come. And when your time is up, your time is bloody well up, and that's it. There's not a chorus, not a singing chorus to it. You just have to shout the answer to us. And it says, Fine Girl Yar!
Fairly well, my lovely time. A thousand times adieu. For we're gone away from the holy ground and the girls we all love true. We will sail the salt sea over, and we'll return for shore to see again the girls we love and the holy ground once more.
Fine girl you are,
you're the girl I do adore, and still I live in hopes to see the holy ground once more. And now the storm is raging, and we are far from shore, and the good old ship is tossing about, and the rigging is all torn. And the secrets of my mind, my love, you're the girl I do adore, and still I live in hopes to see the holy ground once more. You're the girl I do adore, and still I live in hopes to see
storm is over and we are safe and well. We will go into a public house and we'll sit and drink like hell. We will drink strong ale and porter. We'll make the rafters roar. And when our money is all spent, we'll go to sea once more. Yet the girl I do adore, and still I live to see the holy ground. Fine girl you are.
And the wild mountain thyme grows around the blooming heather. Will you go, lassie? Will you go? I will, she said, I will.
Oh, the summer time is coming, and the trees are sweetly blooming, and the wild mountain thyme grows around the blooming heather. Will you go, oh lassie? And we'll all go together to block wild mountain thyme all around the blooming heather. Will you go, oh lassie, go?
I will build my love near yon pure crystal fountain, and on it I will find all the flowers on the mountain. Will you go, oh lassie?
We'll all go.
And we'll all on wild mountain thyme all around the blooming heather. Will you go, oh lassie, go?
If my true love she were gone, I would surely find another where wild mountain thyme grows around the blooming heather. Will you go, oh lassie?
And we'll all go together to block wild mountain thyme all around the blooming heather. Will you go, oh lassie?
Too nice to stop there. Start from the beginning.
Oh, the summer time is come.
The trees are sweetly blooming.
And the trees are sweetly blooming.
The wild mountain thyme.
And the wild around the blooming.
Will you go, lassie?
Will you go, lassie? Go?
And we'll all go together.
And we'll all go together.
To block wild mountain
time. To block wild mountain time. All around. Thank you.
Jesus.
And it's no,
nay,
never, no, nay, never, no more will I play the wild rover. No, never, no more. And it's no,
nay, never, no, nay, never, no more will I play the wild rover. No, never, no more.
Sing it on your own.
And it's no, nay, never, no, nay, never, no more.
She answered me, nay, such a custom as yours I can get any day.
And it's no, nay, never, no, nay, never, no more will I play the wild rover. No, never, no more.
I took from a pocket and supper is bright, I remember, and the landlady's eyes opened wide with delight. She said, I have whiskies and wines of the best. Sure, the words I had spoke were only in jest.
And it's no, nay, never, no, nay, never, no more will I play. My prayers confess what I've done, and I'll ask them to pardon their prodigal son. And if they'll caress me as oft times before, then I never will play the wild.
Well, boys and girls, our revels now are ended. These are actors, as I foretold you. We're all spirits and are melted into air, into thin air. And like the baseless fabric of this vision, the cloud-capped towers, the gorgeous palaces, the solemn temples, the great globe itself. Yea, all which they inherit shall dissolve, and like this insubstantial pageant faded, leave not a rack behind. Where such stuff as dreams are made on, and our little life is rounded with a sleep. And I'm asking you in Shakespeare's words is, have you no homes to go to? Oh, all the money that e'er I spend, I spend it in good company, and all the harm that e'er I've done, alas, it was to none but me. And all I've done for want of wit, to memory now I can't recall. So fill to me the parting glass, good night and joy be with you all. Oh, all the comrades that e'er I've had, they're sorry for my going away. And of all the sweethearts that e'er I've had, they wish me one more day to stay. But since it falls unto my lot that I should rise and you should not, I'll gently rise and I'll softly call, good night and joy be with you all.
Good night to you all. God bless. Thank you very much.
Good night.
May we never die. And farewell.
The banks of the ocean, where the walls rise above the Zuider Sea. Long ago, I used to be a young man, and dear Margaret remembers that for me.
Thank you.
Wet me whack, fall the dough, fall the diddly idly.
And wet me whack, fall the dough, fall the diddly idly. As I rode out through Galway town to seek for recreation, the 17th of August, me mind been elevated. There was multitudes assembled with their tickets at the station. Me eyes began to dazzle and I go on to see the races. Wet me whack, fall the dough, fall the diddly idly.
With sugar sticks and dainties, lozenges and oranges and lemonade and raisins and gingerbread and spices to accommodate the ladies, and a big crew being for toppings to be picking while you're able.
Whip me whack, follow the dough, follow the diddly-idly.
It's there you'll see the pipers and the fiddlers competing, the nimble-footed dancers and the tripping on the daisies, others crying cigars and lights and bells for all the races, with the colour of the jockeys and the price and horses ages.
Whip me whack, follow the dough, follow the diddly-idly.
There was passengers from Limerick and more from Tipperary, the boys from Connemara and the Clare unmarried maidens, and people from Cork City who were loyal, true and faithful. They brought home the Fenian prisoners from dying in foreign nations.
Whip me whack, follow the dough, follow the diddly-idly.
There you see the jockeys and they're bound to dance so stately. The red, the blue, the orange, the green, the emblem of our nation. When the bell was rung for starting, all the horses seemed impatient. I thought they never stood on ground, their speed was so amazing.
Whip me whack, follow the dough, follow the diddly-idly. There was half a million people there of all denominations, the Catholic, the Protestant, the Jew and Presbyterian. There was yet no animosity, no matter what persuasion, but fortune, hospitality, inducing fresh acquaintance. Whip me whack, follow the dough, follow the diddly-idly. Whip me whack, follow the dough, follow the diddly-idly.
When I was a little boy, so my mother told me to me, way haul away, we'll haul away, Joe. That if I did not kiss the girls, my lips would all grow moldy to me, way haul away. Ship now is rolling to me. Way haul away, we'll haul away, Joe.
King Louis was the king of France before the revolution.
Way haul away, we'll haul away, Joe.
And then he got his head cut off. It spoiled his constitution.
Way haul away, we'll haul away, Joe.
St. Patrick was a gentleman. He came from decent people to me.
Way haul away, we'll haul away, Joe.
He built a church in Dublin town and on it put a steeple to me.
Way haul away, we'll haul away, Joe. Now way haul away, we're bound for better weather to me. Way haul away, we'll haul away, Joe.
Up she flew.
Hey.
That's a girl.
I am going
Pocket is her name. And Burgess is the captain of her. They say that she's a floating shame.
Sailed with barges once before, and I think I know him right well. If a man is a seaman, he can get along, but if not, he is sure in hell.
Let's hear you all, Tom.
So
united we will be. It's not the leaving of Liverpool that grieves me, but my darling, when I think of thee. I could remain, for I know it will be some long time before I see you again. So fare thee well, my own true love, and when I return united we will be. It's not the leaving of Liverpool that grieves me, but my darling, when I think of thee.
Once more.
So fare thee well, my own true love, and when I return united we will be. It's not the leaving of Liverpool.
In the year of our Lord, 1806, we sailed out from Cove for New York on a strange ship with a strange cargo. She was known as the Irish Rover.
In the year of our Lord, 1806, we set sail from the cold air port
of Cork.
We were sailing away with the cargo of bricks for the Grand City Hall in New York. We'd an elegant craft, she was rigged fore and aft, and how the trade winds drove her. She had 23 masts, and she stood several masts, and they called her the Irish Rover.
There was Barney McGee from the banks of the Lee, there was Hogan from County Tyrone. There was Johnny McGurk, who was scared stiff of work, and a chap from Westmead named Below.
We had Slugger O'Toole, who was drunk as a rule, fighting Bill Tracy from Dover, and your man Nick McCann from the banks of the Pan was the skipper on the Irish Rover.
We had 1 million bags of the best Sligo rags, near 2 million barrels of bone.
We had 3 million bales of our nanny goat's tail. We had 4 million barrels of stone.
We had 5 million hops and 6 million docks and 7 million barrels of porter. We had 8 million sights of our blind horses hide in the hold of the Irish Rover. We had sailed 7 years when the measles broke out and our ship lost her way in a fog.
Hold it.
They were good. They were
bad.
I wasn't.
That was the most feeble, great fog that I ever heard in
Jesus
my entire life.
Jesus Cockburn, I thought you'd do better than that.
You had two little words, great fog, and you blew it. Right in front of God and the television and everybody, you blew it.
Give me another chance.
Let's try it again. We had sailed
7 years when the measles broke out and our ship lost her way in a fog. And the whale of the crew was reduced down to two, was myself and the captain's old dog. When the ship's rocked a rock, oh Lord, what a shock, and nearly tumbled over, turned nine times around.
Cut. I said cut. You wouldn't bloody well sing when I asked you to sing. And now when I say cut, you're singing.
And the poor old dog was drowned. I'm the last of the Irish Rover.
Okay, bye-bye now. Bye-bye.
God, I have to sit down on this one. I'm getting very old, you know. And the band played Waltzing Matilda. Now when I was a young man, I carried me pack, and I lived the free life of the rover. From the Murray's green basin to the dusty outback, I waltzed my Matilda all over. Then in 1915, my country said, son, it's time to stop rambling, there's work to be done. So they gave me a tin hat and they gave me a gun, and they sent me away to the war. And the band played Waltzing Matilda as the ship pulled
the golden ringlets along. There is never a tear in his blue eyes, but glad and bright are they as young Robbie O'Connell goes to die on the bridge of Tuam today. When he last stepped off the street, his shining Viking heart, behind him marched in grim array, a stalwart earnest band. For Antrim town, for Antrim town, he led them to the fray. And young Roddy McCauley goes to die on the bridge of Tuam today. There is never a one of all your dead who bravely fell in fray, that he who marches to his fate on the bridge of Tuam today. True to the last, true to the last, he treads the upward way. And young Roddy McCauley goes to die on the bridge of Tuam today.
matrimony is a most peculiar institution. And it's a real love-hate relationship. The one thing about it is it goes on too long, for one thing. And there's a... there's a song about a couple who are fed up with each other. And in this case, she tried to get rid of him by going to a quack doctor and getting some ingredients to make him blind. And then when he couldn't see what was happening, she tried to drown him. Here's a little Irish love song from the County Wexford called The Old Woman from Wexford. There was an old woman in Wexford town did dwell. She loved her husband dearly, but another man twice as well. With me rifle little delaynel and me rifle orderly. One day she went to the doctor, some medicine for to find. Said, doctor, give me something that'll make me husband blind. With me rifle little delaynel and me rifle orderly. He said, feed them eggs and marrow bones and make them sup them all. It won't be so very long after that till he won't see you at all. With me rifle, little ladle, and me rifle, orally. So she fed them eggs and marrow bones and make them sup them all. It wasn't so very long after that till he couldn't see the wall. With me rifle, little ladle, and me rifle, orally. Says he, I'd go and drown myself, but that might be a sin. Says she, I'll go to the water's edge and I'll help to push you in. With me rifle, little ladle, and me rifle, orally. The old woman, she went back a bit to get to run and go. The old man lightly stepped aside and she went in below. With me rifle, little ladle, and me rifle, orally. Oh, how loudly did she roar and how loudly did she bawl. And I howled your wished old woman, says he, sure I can't see you at all. With me rifle, little ladle, and me rifle, orally. Now she swam and swam and swam and swam and she came to the further brim. The old man got a long lash pole and he pushed her further in. With me rifle, little ladle, and me rifle, orderly. Now eggs are eggs and marrow bones might make your husband blind. But if you want to drown him, you must creep up close behind. With me rifle, little ladle, and me rifle, orderly.
Back about 12 or 13 years ago, I came across a most unusual song. It was a recently written song, but written about events in the latter half of the last century. A man called Peter Jones, who lives outside Washington, D.C., over in America, came across a bunch of old letters that had been passed down in his family and had survived throughout the years. And they were written by his, rather to his great-great-grandfather from by some of the family back here in Ireland. And it chronicles the family through that very turbulent time at the end of the last century and gives you a real sense of the loss and the separation they felt, the ones who had emigrated. Something like only 1 in 10 that went out to America in those years ever made it back to Ireland again. But the family in Ireland that sent over the letters lived in a place up in County Mayo called Kilkelly.
Ireland, 1860, my dear and loving son John. Your good friend, schoolmaster Pat McNamara, so good as to write these words down. Your brothers have all gone to find work in England. House is so empty and sad. Crop of potatoes is sorely infected, a third to a half of them bad. And your sister Bridget and Patrick O'Donnell are going to be married in June. Your mother says not to work on the railroad, be sure to come on home soon. Thank you. wishes and to your four children. May they grow healthy and strong. Michael has got a wee bit of trouble. I suppose that he never will learn. Because of the dampness, there's no turf to speak of. And now we have nothing to burn. And Bridget is happy, named a child for her, although she's got six of her own. You say you found work, but you don't say what kind or when you will be coming home. Michael and John, my sons, I'm sorry to give you the very sad news that your dear old mother has gone. We buried her down at the church in Kilkelly. Your brothers and Bridget were there. To worry, she died very quickly. Remember her in your prayers. And it's so good to hear that Michael's returning. With money he's sure to buy land. For the crop has been poor and the people are selling at any price that they can. I must be close on 80. It's 30 years since you've gone. Because of all of the money you sent me, I'm still living out on my own. Michael has built himself a fine house, and Bridget's daughters are grown. Sending your family picture, your lovely young women and men. You say that you might even come for a visit. What joy to see you again. Kilkelly, Ireland, 1892. Brother John, I'm sorry I didn't write sooner to tell you that Father passed on. He was living with Bridget. She says he was cheerful and healthy right down to the end. And you should have seen him play with the grandchildren. McNamara, your friend. And we buried him alongside of Mother down at the Kilkelly churchyard. He was a strong and a feisty old man, considering his life was so hard. And it's funny the way he kept talking about you. He called for you.
When we started out first touring Ireland, it was a great pleasure to go to Belfast. There was great energy in that city. And some of the best of our songs came from there. This one was a song we got from an old friend, Davy Hammond, about his childhood when the children would be dancing in and out among the dusty bluebells, as he said. It's called I'll Tell Me Ma When I Go Home That the Boys Won't Leave the Girls Alone.
And sing along with us and enjoy it.
And tell me, Ma, when I go home, the boys won't leave the girls alone. They prune my hair, they store my comb, but that's all right till I go home. She is handsome, she is pretty, she is the belle of Belfast City. She is the fortune, 1, 2, 3, please will you tell me who is he? Mooney says he loves her, all the boys are fighting for her. They're rapping the door, they're ringing the bells. You know, my true love, are you well? Out she comes as white as snow, rings on her fingers, bells on her toes. Oh, Johnny Marr, he says she'll die, she doesn't get the fellow with a roving eye. Let the wind and the rain and the hail blow high, the snow comes traveling from the sky. She's as nice as apple pie, she'll get her own lad by and by. When she gets a lad of her own, she won't tell her ma when she comes home. Let them all come as they will, for his Albert Moody she loves still. And tell me ma, when I go home, the boys won't leave the girls alone. They pull my hair, they stole my comb, but that's all right till I go home. She is handsome, she is pretty, she is the belle of Belfast City. She is a fortune, 1, 2, 3, please will they tell me who is he? Albert Moody says he loves her, all the boys are fighting for her. Rap at the door, they ring at the bell, saying, oh my true love, are you well? Out she comes as white as snow, rings on her fingers, bells on her toes. Oh, Johnny Marr, he says she'll die, she doesn't get the fellow with her roving eye. Let them all come as they will, for it's Albert Moody she loves still.
It was Friday morn when we set sail, and we were not far from the land. When our captain, he spied a mermaid so fair, with the comb and a glass in her hand. And the ocean waves do roll, and the stormy winds do blow, and we poor sailors are skipping at the top, where the land lovers lie down below, 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 where the land lovers lie down below.
Then up spoke the captain of our gallant ship, and a fine old man was he. This fishy mermaid had warned me of our doom, we shall sink to the bottom of the sea.
And the ocean waves do roll, and the stormy winds do blow, and we poor sailors are skipping at the top, where the land lovers lie down below, 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 where the land lovers lie down below.
Of our gallant ship, and a fine young man was he. Saying, I have a wife in Boston by the sea, and tonight a widow she will be.
And the ocean waves do roll, and the stormy winds do blow, and we poor sailors are skipping at the top, where the land lovers lie down below, 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 where the land lovers lie down below.
Then up spoke a cook of our gallant ship, a crazy old butcher was he. Said, I care much more for my pots and my pans I do for the bottom of the sea.
And the ocean waves do roll, and the stormy winds do blow, and we poor sailors are skipping at the top, while the land lovers lie down below, 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 where the land lovers lie down below.
gallant ship, and a well-spoken lad was he. Said, I have a sweetheart and sailing by the sea, and tonight she'll be weeping for me.
And the ocean waves do roar, and the stormy winds do blow, and we poor sailors are skipping at the top, where the landlubbers lie down below, 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 where the landlubbers lie down below. And three times round spun our gallant ship, and three times round spun she, and three times round spun our gallant ship, and she sank to the bottom of the sea. And the ocean waves do roar, and the stormy winds do blow,
and the morning,
and we poor sailors are skimming at the top, while the landlubbers lie down below, 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 while the landlubbers lie down below.
Thank you. That was the story of the mermaid. And in case you don't know it, or don't know us, our nephew, Robbie O'Connell.
How you doing?
And Liam Clancy. Bobby Clancy. And the new generation, Finbar Clancy. Finbar is Bobby's son, and I'm their father, Paddy Clancy.
Yes, go on. The handsomest, the richest.
The youngest, the handsomest, and the richest.
The richest, by far. That's certainly truth, yes. No two ways about that.
And the bitchiest, we forgot to add that.
Well, I have to be the shanty man, since you were all something in that bloody song except me. I feel very left out.
Oh, get the fiddle out quick, will you?
This is kind of a sad occasion, isn't it, really? It was 1954 since I stood on this stage the last time with the Playboy of the Western World on its countrywide tour from Carrick to Clonmel and back. I got a long way. Well, this is our last hurrah, so it's nice to have you all here tonight and be part of this. The herring are not in the tide as they were of old, my sorrow. For many's the creek gave the creel of the cart that carried the take to Sligo town to be sold. When I was a boy with never a crack in my heart. With our nets and gear, we're faring on the wild and wasteful ocean. It's out there on the deep that we harvest and reap our bread. As we hunt the bunny shoals of herring. It was on a fair and a pleasant day, out of Yarmouth Harbour I was faring, as a cabin boy on a sailing lugger, for to hunt the bunny shoals of herring. Oh, we left the home grounds in the month of June, and for canny shields we soon were bearing, with the 100 crown of the silver darlings that we'd taken from the shoals of herring. Now the work was hard and the hours were long, and the treatment sure it took some bearing, and I used to sleep
about shoals of Tipperary. Now you're up on deck, you're a fisherman, and you're learning all about seafaring. That's your education, straps of navigation, as you hunt the funny shoals of Tipperary. Stormy seas and the living gales, I earned the gear that I was wearing. Sailed 10,000 miles, caught 10 million fishes, as we hunted for the shoals of Erin.
And it's night and day, we're faring. Come winter wave, our winter gale, sweating our coat, growing up, growing old, or dying. We will hunt the funny shoals of Erin.
Too soon to tell that story, isn't it?
Our brother Tom died about 5 years ago. Rest his soul. Tom and I grew up together. We went through that worst part of anyone's life together. That's puberty. We were absolutely terrified. I remember the first dance we went to. We were so excited and so nervous. A combination of excitement and nervousness can make you do almost anything. But we had the problem of getting the money to get into the dance. We could always coax that out of our mother, but we couldn't. We had to get a little more money for a small bottle of Courage, Power's gold-labeled whiskey, a baby Power. And we had to keep this a hide from our parents. Tom had it in his back pocket a hide, and we were upstairs combing our hair for the 16th time, making sure our tie was straight and the shirt was clean. It was getting nearer and nearer the time for the dance, and we were getting more nervous all the time. Eventually, we had to leave. Down the stairs, Tom slipped on the bloody stairs. There was an awful crash. He put back his hand. He felt the wet. He looked up at me and he said, "Paddy, I hope it's blood."
And that dance was in the Collins Hall, wasn't it?
Well, it was in the Forester's Hall in Carrick, I'm sure. And here's a little song, Mountain Dew.
Hi, diddly-idle-lum, 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 diddly-idle-lum.
Let grasses grow and waters flow in a free and easy way, but give me enough of the fine old stuff that's made near Galway Bay. And these men all from Donegal, Sligo and Leitrim too, we'll give them the slip when we take a sip at the real old Mountain Dew.
Aye, diddly, idle, lum, diddly, you, diddly, lum, diddly, you, ride, diddly, I, day. Aye, diddly, idle, lum, diddly, you, diddly, lum, diddly, you, ride, diddly, I, day.
At the foot of the hill there's a neat little still where the smoke curls up to the sky. By the smoke and the smell you can plainly tell that the butchin brew a nearby. It fills the air with odor rare and betwixt both me and you, when home you stroll you can take a bowl of the bucket at the Mountain Dew.
Aye, diddly, idle, lum, diddly, you, diddly, lum, diddly, you, ride, diddly, I, day. Aye, diddly, idle, lum, diddly, you, diddly, lum, diddly, you, ride, diddly, I, day.
Now learned men who use the pen have wrote your praises high. That sweet poutine from Ireland's green is still from wheat and rye. Throw away your pills and cure all ills, be a pagan, a Christian, a Jew. Take off your coat and grease your throat from the real old Mountain Dew.
Thank you. In the 18th century, rebellion seemed to break out all over the world. You had the French Revolution, you had the American War of Independence, and in Ireland here we had the rebellion of 1798. That rebellion is now mostly remembered for one young man who played a very brave part in it. And for his effort, he was hanged by the neck in his own hometown, Tombridge, County Antrim. His name was Roddie McCorley.
Oh, see the fleet-foot hosts of men who speed with faces wan. From farmstead and from fisher's cot along the banks of Bann, they come with vengeance in their eyes. Too late are they. For young Roddy McCorley goes to die on the bridge of Toome today. Up that narrow street he stepped, smiling proud and young. About the hemp rope on his neck.
It's the grand ball.
You know, this group has been on the road a long, long,
long,
long, long, long, long time. And back in that time, when it was kind of dangerous to sing, if you know what I mean, you had to go to all sorts of peculiar places. There was no such thing as the hotels. There was always a little dust house here somewhere or else.
Lousy
lodgings, as Paddy says. And one of the worst places, I suppose, we ever stayed was a little place outside Glasgow. And here's a story about that particular night. It was the night that we spent in Rozio.
Dirrum-a-doo-a-dum-a-day, dirrum-a-doo-a-dad-o. Dirrum-a-doo-a-dum-a-day, the night we went to Rozio.
One New Year's Eve in Glasgow town, when all we had was half a crown. A bunch of us thought we'd prowl around and find some fun in Rozio.
We wandered down Victoria Street and we didn't care for the snow or sleet. And at 2:30 with aching feet, we found ourselves in Rozio.
Dirrum-a-doo-a-dum-a-day, dirrum-a-doo-a-dad-no. Dirrum-a-doo-a-dum-a-day, the night we went to Rozio.
Liam Clancy here, who's a bit of a lout, said he'd treat us all to a pint of stout. So as quick as a wink, we all set out for the public house in Rozio.
Said I, my lads, I'd like to sing.
Said I, I'll no do such a thing.
I said, clear the room and we'll make a ring and I'll fight you all in Rozio.
Dirrum-a-doo-a-dum-a-day, dirrum-a-doo-a-dad-no. Dirrum-a-doo-a-dum-a-day, the night we went to Rozio.
Then we had to find a place to sleep.
We were all too drunk to even creep.
We found a place that was really cheap in a boarding house in Rozio.
Then we all lay down to take our ease when somebody happened for to sneeze.
And we can have a million fleas in a single room in Rozio. Dirrum-a-doo-a-dum-a-day, dirrum-a-doo-a-dad-no. Dirrum-a-doo-a-dum-a-day, the night we went to Rozio.
There were several different kinds of pests.
They ran and jumped inside our vests.
They got in our hair and they built their nests. And they cried,
"Hurrah, Marazio!"
Says I think we'll head for home.
And we swore we never more would roam. And we're scratching still as we sing the song of the night we went to Rossio. Dinner-ma-doo-a-dum-a-day, dinner-ma-doo-a-dad-no. Dinner-ma-doo-a-dum-a-day, the night we went to Rossio. Dinner-ma-doo-a-dum-a-day, dinner-ma-doo-a-dad-no. Dinner-ma-doo-a-dum-a-day, the night we went to Rossio.
Back in the early days when we were starting out in Greenwich Village in New York, there was a character who used to come to all the shows, a young fellow about 17 or 18 named Robert Zimmerman, better known now as the legendary Bob Dylan. But he used to follow us around and he'd make songs, his own songs, to the different tunes that we would sing. I remember meeting him on the street one morning and he was always dancing around kind of with the balls of his toes, you know. He said, "Hey, man, hey, I wrote a song last night to Brendan on the Moor. You want to hear it?" It was Brendan on the Moor was our big opening song at the time. And I said, "I'm in a terrible rush. I'm going to rehearsal. How many verses are in it?" He said, "Only 17, man." I said, "Well, could you give me 5 of them? You know, like there's only 4 of us in the group and a chorus." He said, "Man, it's a story. I got to tell you the whole thing." And he sang it for me right there on the street. I instantly forgot it. Anyway, the song that we're going to sing is Bob Dylan's version of Willie Brennan. He changed it to be about a gambling man down in the Mississippi River. And it's the very first track on a new album that we have out. How ironical now that this is our farewell concert tour, that a very brand new album is about to come on the shelves.
Well, really, it's the first of our farewell tours, really.
Who do you think you are, Frank Sinatra? But at the irony of it is that it should also be called Older But No Wiser.
Right, Myra?
And Bobby's wife, Myra, is the one who named it and christened it with several bottles of champagne. Here's the story of Willie Connolly, Ramblin' Gamblin' Willie.
Come around, you roving gamblers, the story we will tell about the greatest gambler, you all should know him well. His name was Willie Connolly, and he gambled all his life. He had 27 children, yet he never had a wife. And it's right, Willie, right. Roll, Willie, roll, wherever you're a gambling, now nobody really knows.
Sailing down the Mississippi to the town of New Orleans, there was a famous card game on the Jackson River Queen. "I've come to win some money," old gambling Willie said. And when the game was ended up, the whole damn boat was his.
And it's right, Willie, right. Roll, Willie, roll, wherever you're a gambling, now nobody really knows.
Up in the Rocky Mountains in a town called Cripple Creek, they had an all-night poker game that lasted about a week. 900 miners that lay their money down. When Willie finally left the room, he owned the whole damn town.
And it's right, Willie, right. Roll, Willie, roll, wherever you're a gambling, now nobody really knows.
Now Willie had a heart of gold, and this I know is true. He supported all his children and all their mothers too. He wore no rings or fancy things like other gamblers wore. He spread his money far and wide to help the sick and poor.
And it's right, Willie, right. Roll, Willie, roll, wherever you're a gambling, now nobody really knows.
Late one fateful evening as they played a poker game, a man lost all his money, he said Willie was to blame. He shot poor Willie through the heart, it was a tragic fate. When Willie's cards fell on the floor, there were aces backed with eights.
And it's right, Willie, right. Roll, Willie, roll, wherever you're a gambling, now nobody really knows. So all you roving gamblers, wherever you might be,
The moral of this story is very plain to see. Make your money while you can before you have to stop. For when you pull a dead man's hand, your gambling days are up and it's ride, Willie, ride. Roll, Willie, roll. Wherever you're a gambling now, nobody really knows. Ride, Willie, ride. Roll, Willie, roll. Wherever you're a gambling now, nobody really knows.
Plug in.
This is a very different kind of a love song. It's about an old couple who know what love is all about because their love has been tempered by the tough times as well as the good times. And there's an awful lot of friendship gone into it, which is really what it's all about in the long run when everything else gives out. Right, Bobby?
Paddy. It was Paddy last night, it was me tonight. Aleem's time is coming, let's face it, his time is coming.
We're all like old cars, bits falling off here and bits falling off there.
Speak for yourself, son.
I know my clutch is gone anyway. What was I saying? I won't. Just for that now, I won't bloody well sing it at all.
Well, sing it anyway.
It's about an old couple who live in a flat in Amsterdam in Holland. The old man is a bit shell-shocked. Or maybe he's, as we say down in Carrick, he's just away with the fairies. But he wanders off down by the canals of Amsterdam in the morning, shouting at the captains of the barges and the tugboats as they pass by. He thinks he knows them all from his youth in Rotterdam. But as the day wears on, he can't remember who he is or where he is or how to get home. And his old wife, Margaret, has to go and find him. I'm very fond of Margaret. She brings him back through the cobbled streets of Amsterdam. And in the cold of the evening, she puts a little whiskey in his tea to warm him up and cheer him up. If I could find a woman like that, oh my God. If I could find a cup of tea like that. Lovely chorus to it if you want to sing it nice and soft with us. It says, let us go to the banks of the ocean where the walls rise above the Zuider Zee. Long ago I used to be a young man and dear Margaret remembers that for me. Called the Dutchman. The Dutchman's not the kind of man to keep his thumb jammed in the dam that holds his dreams in. But that's a secret only Margaret knows. When Amsterdam is golden in the morning, Margaret brings him breakfast. She believes him. He thinks the tulips bloom beneath the snows. He's mad as he can be, but Margaret only sees that sometimes. Sometimes she sees her unborn children in his eyes. Let us go to the banks of the ocean where the walls rise above the Zuider Zee. Long ago I used to be a young man and dear Margaret remembers that for me. Dutchman still wears wooden shoes, his cap and coat are patched with love, like Margaret sewed him. Sometimes he thinks he's still in Rotterdam. He watches tugboats down canals and calls out to them when he thinks he knows the captain.
till Margaret comes to take him home again. Through unforgiving streets that trip him though she holds his arm. Sometimes he thinks that he's alone and he calls her name. Let us go to the banks of the ocean, where the walls rise above the cider sea. Long ago, I used to be a young man, and dear Margaret remembers that for me. The windmills swirl the winter in, she winds his muffler tighter. They sit in the kitchen. The tea with whiskey keeps away the dew. He sees her for a moment, calls her name. She makes his bed up, humming some old love song. She learned it when the tune was very new. He hums a line or two, they hum together in the night. The Dutchman falls asleep and Margaret blows the candle out. Let us go to the banks of the ocean, where the walls rise above the cider sea. Long ago, I used to be a young man, and dear Margaret remembers that for me. Sing it once with us. Let us go to away from the quay, and amid all the tears, flag waving and cheers, we sail off for Gallipoli. Well, I remember that terrible day when our blood stained the sand and the water, and how in that hell that they called Suvla Bay, we were butchered like lambs at the slaughter. Johnny Turk, he was ready, oh, he'd primed himself well. He rained us with bullets and he showered us with shell. And in 5 minutes flat, we were all blown to hell. Nearly blew us back home to Australia. And the band played Waltzing Matilda when we stopped to bury our slain. We buried ours, and the Turks buried theirs. Then it started all over again. Those who are living just try to survive in that mad world of blood, death, and fire. And for 10 weary weeks, I kept myself alive, though around me the corpses piled higher. Then a big Turkish shell knocked me arse overhead, and when I awoke in my hospital bed and saw what it had done, then I wished I were dead. I never knew there were worse things than dying, for no more I'll go waltzing Matilda all around the green bush far and near. For to hump tent and pegs, a man needs both legs. No more waltzing Matilda for me. They collected the wounded, the crippled, the maimed, and they shipped shipped us back home to Australia. The armless, the legless, the blind, the insane, those proud, wounded heroes of Suvla. And when the ship pulled into Circular Quay, I looked at the place where my legs used to be, and thank Christ, there was no one there waiting for me. To grieve and to mourn and to pity. And the band played Waltzing Matilda as they carried us down the gangway. But nobody cheered, they just stood there and stared. Then they turned all their faces away. So now, every April, I sit on my porch and I watch the parade pass before me. And I see my old comrades, how proudly they march, renewing their dreams of past glory. I see the old men, all tired, stiff and sore, the weary old heroes of a forgotten war. And the young people ask, what are they marching for? And I ask myself the same question. And the band plays Waltzing Matilda, and the old men still answer the call. But as year follows year, more old men disappear. Someday no one will march there at all. Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda, who'll come a waltzing Matilda with me? And their ghosts may be heard as they march by the billabong. Who'll come a waltzing Matilda with me?
We're going to sing an old favorite of ours, a song we've been singing for at least 65 years. It's a song we learned donkeys years ago here in Ireland. An old man taught it to us. An old man whose whole life had been sweetened by the drinking of punch. And one night in this pub, he'd been there all day, he growled out this song for us as the world was slipping out of focus for him. The song that starts out very quietly and very poetically, and rapidly deteriorates. We'd like you to join us in a jug of punch.
One pleasant evening in the month of June, as I was sitting with my glass and spoon, a small bird sat on an ivy bunch, and the song he sang was the jug of punch. Tooraloo, 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 tooraloo. A small bird sat on an ivy bunch, and the song he sang was the jug of punch.
What more diversion can a man desire than to sit him down by an alehouse fire? Upon his knee a pretty wench, aye, and on the table a jug of punch. The doctors come with all their art, they'll make no impression upon my heart. Even the cripple forgets his punch when he's snug outside of a jug of punch. If I get drunk, well, the money's me own. And them don't like me, they can leave me alone. I'll shun me fiddle and I'll rosin me bow. And I'll be welcome wherever I go. While we're on the subject, Ishkabaha is the water of life, the origin of the word whiskey. There was a builder's laborer in Dublin in the last century who was very fond of the same water of life. And one Monday morning, after a wonderful weekend, he felt awful. He had the mother and father of a hangover. But being a builder's laborer, he still had to climb that ladder with a hod full of bricks. So to give himself a little courage, the poor man, he took a drop of the hard stuff. The result of which was, when he got to the top of the ladder, he got a dizzy spell. He fell, broke his skull, dead as a doornail. They say it was a drop that killed him.
Tim Philip did a walk on the street, a gentle Irishman mighty odd. He had a brogue so rich and sweet, and a rise in the world he carried a hob. You see, in a sort of a tippler's way, when the love for the liquor poor Tim was born, to help him on with his work each day, the drop of the crater every morn. Back on the nano, dancing a partner, went the floor, your father's shame. Wasn't it the truth that told you lots of fun and filling his wake?
One morning Tim felt rather full, his head felt heavy, which made him shake. He fell from a ladder and he broke his skull, and they carried him home, his corpse to wake. They rolled him up in a nice clean sheet, and they laid him out upon the bed, with a bucket of whiskey at his feet and a barrel of porter at his head.
Whack for the nano, dance your partner, wipe the floor, your trotter's shake. Wasn't it the truth that showed you lots of fun and Finnegan wake?
His friends assembled at the wake, and Mrs. Finnegan called for lunch, but she served them tea and cakes, Then pipes, tobacco, and whiskey punch, Biddy O'Brien began to cry. What a nice clean corpse did you ever see? Tim of morning, why did you die? And how was your cop, said Billy McGee.
And fight for the land of mercy, your partner, went to blow your trotter shake. Positive the truth, they told you lots of fun at Finnegan's Wake.
And Maggie O'Connor took up the job. Oh, Biddy, says she, you're wrong, I'm sure. But Biddy Gay wore a belt in the gob, and she left her sprawling on the floor.
And the ward is soon engaged, was woman to woman and man to man. Shillelagh law was all the rage, and a row and a ruction soon began. Back for the man who had seen a partner went to floor your trotter shake. Wasn't it the truth they told you lots of fun at Finnegan's Wake?
Mickey Maloney ducked his head when a bucket of whiskey flew at him. It missed and fallen on the bed. The liquor scatters over Tim. And by God, he revives. See how he rises. Timothy rising from the bed. Saying, whirl your whiskey around like blazes. On a mundane, do you think I'm dead?
Whack for the lad who danced your partner, went to floor your trotter shake. Wasn't it the truth they told you lots of fun at Finnegan's Wake? Whack for the lad who danced your partner, went to floor your trotter shake. Wasn't it the truth they told you lots of fun at Finnegan's Wake?
How's your own one? We're going to finish up with this one, believe it or not, because our time has come. And when your time is up, your time is bloody well up, and that's it. There's not a chorus, not a singing chorus to it. You just have to shout the answer to us. And it says, "Fine girl, you are!"